Hi there. The purpose of this presentation is to go over a few of the potential sources of demographic data. And we can do that at different levels. We're going to start at the national level. And of course, the first stop when we mention population should be the Population Census Bureau. They have a lot of different types of data available. And they also have a lot of different ways of retrieving that data. And the data are organized at several different levels of analysis. But the American Fact Finder might be the more simple way of reviewing some of the data that are available, but there are also different topics covered in the county level data, and one can also order the summary file DVDs. The census isn't the only U.S. government source of demographic data. We can also turn to the National Centers for Health Statistics, or in the Center for Disease Control. These have, of course, health and disease-related data, which are going to be more closely related to mortality and deaths. We have the Bureau of Labor Statistics, which has to do with the structure of the economy, of occupations, different types of employment, and the Department of Agriculture, county-level data sets, of course, cover the obvious, agriculture, food, but also some other related topics. So there's a lot we can look at in terms of national data. If we take a quick look at the census website for county data, you do see this unfortunate statement here that for some reason this project is no longer going to be supported, the county level data, but there's still some existing data available to download here, and you can see the range of topics from accommodation and food services, agriculture, ancestry. So essentially a collection of economic, demographic, agricultural data, and really what the census has done is pulled together data from different channels, including the Department of Agriculture, the Bureau of Labor Statistics, and the Centers for Disease Control. So this is a really handy resource, but now you're going to have to go to the originals in the future. But if you're looking at some older data, you can download the Excel files here, or the entire shebang in these zip files, which hold multiple Excel files. In fact, if we were to download the source documentation from the census website, we would see all the different places where the data have come from. You can see there, Census Bureau, Bureau of Labor Statistics, American Medical Association, CDC, SAGE Publications, Department of Commerce, Department of Education, Department of Justice, Social Security Administration, Department of Treasury, Department of Agriculture, and U.S. Geological Survey. And these are the links. And you can download this file if we go back to the census website where it's embedded in this statement is a link, so you can go to those original sources to continue receiving data going into the future. And if we go to the USDA county level data set page, we can see a little more limited offering, but if we click on some of these topics, we can also get to important data that way. We have poverty data, population data, we have economic data, unemployment, unemployment, median household income, and we have education data. And these are all, I believe all of them are available in Excel format. And finally, if we come to the CDC data website, you can actually browse by topic. And here you'll find a very lengthy list of data files, 663 results. This is without any filtering at all, so that's the whole thing. And you can just kind of get a sense as you go through. There's different types of disease data files you can download, different types of death that you can study, such as motor vehicle death rates, alcohol, tobacco, Lyme disease. Yeah. So if you're interested in medical topics and studying mortality in depth, then this would be a good place to visit.